He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Working from the gun, Rodgers. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. It's a four-yard pickup, and it'll be second and 11. Second down, here's Rodgers. First down, and a big loss here as he's taken down. Cameron Wake in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
This is Cobb with a catch right side. A heck of a play there on third down, but amazingly, they're still short for fourth.
Well, I think everything was impressive about that one, except they didn't get a first down. But I like their field position now after that play.
Yeah, now you got a pretty makeable field goal opportunity. The decision to go for it pays off, and now they're set up first and goal.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of rubbed their nose in it. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Flash those fast feet, but they'll drop him at the five-yard line as he can't get any closer to the end zone. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of five. Now Rodgers on the bootleg, on the move to his left, and it's caught, and he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Lance Kendricks, a five-yard touchdown, and the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And the Dolphins getting set to go here. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. Let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before.
Now Cutler in trouble, he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
On second down, here's Cutler. Flush to his right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Here's Cutler to throw. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Kenny Clark in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. And they'll move to get Cutler off the field. He stays out there, and they're going to go for it. They'll indeed go for it with Cutler. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Kenny Clark in there to get him for his second sack of the night. Well, it's gutsy to go for it in the red zone. The problem there is they were in their own red zone. Why in the world did they do that? And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. A great effort there. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Packers have taken the lead. And it's up and good. That pushes the lead now to 15-7. Crosby on now to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. The Dolphins offense now ready to go back out onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the left.
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Amon Brooks in there to drop it for his second sack now here tonight. On second down, Cutler. Try to lay one up deep. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up. Because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun. And they missed an opportunity.
And it's caught by Parker. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
Absolutely zero surprise at that throw we just saw. I mean, Jay Cutler has a whip for an arm.
He's had it since he won a state title at Heritage Hills High School in Southern Indiana.
Where in Southern Indiana, though?
Well, he's born in Santa Claus. How about that?
That's pretty strong right there.
Nearby to my hometown of Evansville. Bet you've never been there, have you?
I have not been there, but I'm looking forward to being invited for a holiday
cheer. You're invited. Put that on your bucket list.
Thank you.
A gain of 32 that time. From the red zone now, here's Cutler on first down. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Montrevious Adams in there to get him for a loss of five. Now Cutler to throw on second down. The swing pass caught, and he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Devontae Parker, 26 yards. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
All incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there. And it'll be second down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Rodgers now on first down. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. A good convergence there defensively. Only a yard, and it's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. A final shot before half for Rodgers. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. Well, we're going to let you off a little easy there, LR. Halftime interrupted, and we are ready to get to this third quarter. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game. We'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offense is.
Packer pressure, and down he goes. Kenny Clark in there to get him again. The third time he sacked him here tonight. Second down, it's Drake. He's able to get four back on the run, but now they'll have to find something here on third and about 14.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Devon House.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Got it complete to Rodgers. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's in...
And trying to get it to his tight end, Rodgers, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10. And he will score. Touchdown, Miami. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now the Packers get set to go. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Throwing now is Rodgers. Let's it go for... And that's caught inside the 35. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, you start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field that's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
A first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. Rodgers going to throw. Got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams from 13 yards out. And the Packers have drawn even here with the extra point to come. Crosby on now to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Out comes the Dolphin offense now as they get set to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he's got the hookup with Anthony Fasano. And he's brought down after a good game. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Now a handoff for Drake. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Good. Now let's go.
Now Cutler looking to throw. Buying time to his... Now Cutler in trouble. He lost the football. A call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. They don't care if it was luck or skill, but the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you retain possession, that's all you're looking for.
It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first. Pitch out to Drake, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given a little time to actually find
nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Montrevious Adams in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
That's his second sack of the game, and the best defensive ends, they do their homework as much as offensive guys do. They know how to beat the offensive lineman across from them, what moves they need to do to set them up. This guy's been pretty good at it all game long.
Now Cutler, and the pressure gets to him again. Kenny Clark in there again. My goodness, that is now his 4th sack tonight.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time.
Looks for Parker, and it's intercepted. And it's Ha-Ha Clinton-Dix with a pick. And the return stops at the 39-yard line. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised, but that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. To throw is Rodgers.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
A very solid gain of 27. So the D-line's going to spread out. A give to Jones. And not much running room. Down to the 32. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, look credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Give him 3 on the play, and it'll be fourth down. And this one is right down the middle. Back now at Lambeau. It's Packer football here as they've got the lead as well.
Oh,
Crosby on now to kick it away. Jakeem Grant now to return. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. And out come the Dolphins now. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, This too shall pass. And finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something
heads up
to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. They stay on the ground with Drake. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. They're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. Just a short pickup. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Off the play fake. Here's Cutler. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Quentin Dial in there to get him for a loss of 9. And that'll lead to fourth down. Here we go. It's Cutler on fourth down. And no, it's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. Now a handoff. Running left is Jones. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6. Now Rodgers. And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And did he put that on a dime? He did. Wow, out of bounds at the 1-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, there's no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
And they'll get him down up past the 15. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Now the ball comes loose, and the Packers pick it up. And they'll be inside the red zone with the ball at the 16-yard line.
Man, I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Again, this to Jones. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. As he's brought down at the five. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah,
then
that's right.
With the Eagles.
That's right. Then with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the cut route.
And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Blake Martinez. And he'll bring it back to about the 5-yard line. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner, forget starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone from the 10-yard line in.
And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of the night. And his guys capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. Whoa! He just yanked that one well to the left and no good. Crosby on now to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. So now here come the Dolphins. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers. We're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays. Oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there. Hope that your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all of that yardage. That
was in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Amon Brooks bringing the pressure again, and that is his third sack here tonight. They go play action with Cutler. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And that is incomplete. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And now, goodness, possession's going to go over right at the 10-yard line. Now Jones. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. Rodgers to throw on second down. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. I guess this is how you define backs against the wall. You have a long way to go. You're down by more than a score.
And the defense really isn't going to allow you to get a big play, but sometimes you just have to force it.
And look out, a big hit to the shoulder pads took him right off his feet at the 8-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Now it's Cutler. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The Dolphins on third down. They're right at about the league average, 40%, 4 for 10. This is third and four. Now a handoff. Here's Williams. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Yeah, that's pretty symptomatic about how things have gone here. That play was just shut down right from the start.
And not going to give him a lot of confidence to help turn things around.
Flushed out right. And this is caught. He hits Landry. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And the Packers pick it up. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, that drive wasn't a case of wanting to put points on the board. It was needing
they
to,
had to
having
had
to, and they didn't get it done.
Yeah, didn't get it done, and now you look at the situation and the point differential, two scores, pretty much game, set, match.
How about the takeaway, though, huh? How about those defensive guys?
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Good gain there on first down. That keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything.
And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Andre Branch in there to get him the 6th time they've sacked him tonight. Now Rodgers. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Adams. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. This is Jones. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more, little insult to injury here late in the game. He hit his first. Now this from 43. And Crosby can't get it to come back. It's no good. Wide to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
It looked good when it left his foot, but he kind of sliced it a little bit, and he winds up missing it wide right.
One last shot for Cutler. He's going to let it fly. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made.
And check where the errors are, how they're going to of that many points.
I come here today to talk about how I feel, and I feel like that we are treated differently than other people, and I don't like how we're treated, and just because of us doesn't mean anything to me.
It's just the way I feel. Hustling, man, I've been putting in these hours. The government been trying to take it where it's ours. Really all about the money and the power. I just want to see my people in power. Tell me how we gonna shape this vision. Complaining all day, but in the same condition. If you want to make change, it's gonna take commitment. Some people enslaved by their religion. Can't emancipate the fundamental principles. When I see through optics, transform the wisdom. Watch me use my prophets, get them on the listen. I've been on a mission. And I really can't take it no more. My temptations, my Lord, I'm young and I'm restless. So reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me? I said, Lord, can you help me? Now everybody.
everybody got fights. Yeah, but wouldn't know what good advice was. Till I leave him lifeless. Another mama crying, it's another crisis. Lord knows we're just trying to live righteous. Are you willing just to make the sacrifices? I know we can't continue living like this. And I never sell my soul, cause that's priceless. Tell me how we gonna make a living. Hustle on the block, who gonna save the children? Man, it's all a plot, and I'm just revealing. The media just trying to make a villain. I just take the pain to paint a picture. Voices in my head, I hear the whispers when I feel this way. And I really can't take it no more. I've been fighting temptations, my Lord. I'm young and I'm restless.
And I really can't help it.
I never felt selfish before. I've been living so reckless, I know. Tell me, Lord, can you help me?
I said, Lord, can you help me?
It's just the way I feel. My been wasting so long.
Everybody might see my pain. Off the rail, might myself. Bored with life as I board this plane. Steward this sex if I need help. Maybe with your last name. Hopefully it still ain't been changed. Something about you make me not doubt your awkward silence. My brain scream louder. Asking when I'm gonna myself. Couple problems, my cash ain't help. Human issues too strong for tissue. False provider, won't mask my wealth. Make my moves, I can't miss my flight and miss you too, boo. First class seats is overrated. Won't go unless they overpay us. Nowadays I'm overdating my district for to hurt. Stay well acquainted, their morning is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need, all I need, all I need.
Move your body if you came here to party. If not, then pardon me. How I'm supposed to have. I'm out of my mind, the sound the sunshine is calling me. Good vibrations is all I need, all I need, all I need.
Party people, yeah. Yeah. Party people, I like to see you dance.
falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. This is Madden 18 on EA Sports. Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's Newton's Panthers going up against Rodgers' Packers.
We are at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. From UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. Finding room at the 30. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. That good for 19 and a first down.
It should go without saying that anytime you run the football well and gain a nice chunk of yardage, that means the offensive line did their job and did it really well. But let's give them a little more credit than that. Because all week long, offensive line meetings, they're going over adjustments, counters, when they line shifts, all those things that go along with it. And yet, you still have to be physical. And that's what they did on the first play.
That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Rodgers to throw on 3rd and 1. Dancing to his left. Got a man. It's his tight end, Lance Kendricks. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he takes it across midfield to the 45. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
That one goes for 24 yards. Jones. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they...
And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Julius Peppers in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. To throw, it's Rodgers. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 11. Muscles him off, and he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
They'll run. This is Jonathan Stewart. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
On second down, here's Newton. He completes it to Stewart. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
The throw on second down is Newton. Throw left side complete. That's Shepard. Now a loose football. The ball comes out and the Packers pick it up.
He makes so many catches that are so tough, so acrobatic, so difficult, that often surprises me when they actually turn the ball over. You know, when the ball actually comes free. It's amazing sometimes because of what we see them do on so many different plays.
Had the catch, but couldn't control it on the contact. Now Jones looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the backfield. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
No gain that time, and it leaves them with third and 11 coming up. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And that is incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot, and this will remain.
Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it, and this one winds up no good.
So the missed 56-yarder, and now the flip side. Good starting field position at the 46 near midfield. They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart, and able to push his first down run, and it's second and four.
Good, strong run against the 3-4 set, and that 3-4, you've got to have your guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 12. Al Stewart on first down. He'll fight forward for a... And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll try the air now with Newton. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Out of the gun, Newton. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Clay Matthews able to drop it for a loss of 12. And it'll be fourth down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And boy, that one drops incomplete. But if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and five, third and six, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
Easy.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, second quarterback. Fresh set of downs here. They'll go again to Jones. And some room to maneuver. And now running right through it. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. 34 yards there and a first down.
You know, it's really hard for a big-time running back is patience. Being able to hang in there when the runs aren't there, when you're taking some hits early in the game. This drive, oh, he's come alive, and in a big way. Now he's starting to gallop.
Steps away to his left. He's to the 10, and he'll be out of bounds all the way down at the 5-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a first down again.
Obviously, a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
So a loss of 5, and it'll be second down. Now they'll throw with Rodgers being chased out left. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down. The offense on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here. Here's Jones. Call it no gain on the play, so no help there. And now fourth and goal.
Now I would be surprised if they go for it. 3 points is not ideal. It's not what they want, but it's still only the first half. Take the 3 points and move on.
And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. Mike McCarthy took the gamble, didn't pay off. And it'll be a turnover on downs. They start on the ground. This is Stewart on first. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. Here's Newton now on 2nd down. And he'll be taken down for a loss back at the 3. So he loses 3 yards there. Now 3rd down. They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on 3rd down. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down.
As much as I praise teams for being true to who they are, in this situation, I wonder if maybe they outguessed themselves a little bit. 3rd down, seemed like an obvious passing situation. They chose to run it and then get anywhere close to the 1st down.
Now Newton, and he can't get away. Newton can't escape the pressure, and it's a safety. So after a scoreless first quarter, we at least finally get some points on the board.
But it can't be what either of us expected, can it?
No, the safety's not what you expect for the first points of the game, but One of the goose eggs is gone. So a free kick situation forthcoming from the 20 as they'll punt this one away. This is taken at about the 14. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. Forced out to his left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Yeah, not much there that time, and I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away, and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
The Packers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's third and two. Here's Rodgers. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked by Darrell Worland. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback rolling left and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
Not good, and we saw the result. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. This is Stewart again. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up 3rd and 5.
Well, not a huge game there as we head towards the 2-minute warning. It'll be interesting to me to see what they decide to do after the timeout.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Newton now to throw. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. On first down, Newton. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Back to the air, Newton on second down. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. They'll try and run it. Here's Stewart. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling.
We tend to give those running backs that are slashers a lot of credit, but how about guys who are maulers? Because that's what you want in short yardage situations, and we just saw that occur right there, didn't we?
Vertical, downhill running. Newton on first down. He shakes him off. Eluding the pressure right. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Newton. And caught left side, Olsen. And now we won't see a play on 1st down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Newton turns and hands to Stewart. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. They keep it on the ground again to Stewart. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. And a stoppage here, a timeout before this third down play takes place. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
One of the things I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This will be a 34-yard attempt. And Gano's kick is right through. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. The play fake to Stewart. It's Newton. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Kenny Clark able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five. So now Cam leads the Panthers up following the sack. Carolina facing third and long. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Third and long. It's Newton. Flush to his right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. The scramble good for a nice gain of 10 yards, but still fourth down.
Well, it's not going to be a first down, but that's a nice job of picking up yardage on third and long. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you, and in this case, it wasn't enough to pick up the first down.
Now let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. They are going to go for it. It's Newton. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. Here's a give to Jones running left. And he'll get about five here as he'll take this down inside the 20-yard line.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
And that's a nice pickup of the first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight. He was out there waving his arms. I mean, you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help. I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
The Packers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. Rodgers now to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
So he missed a field goal earlier, but he says not this time, and he's able to knock it through to give his guys 3.
And that's all you want as a kicker, a chance to redeem yourself. You got to have a short memory if you're going to survive at this level, and he's able to get back on track.
And onto the field, here come the Panthers. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Now it's Newton. This one complete to Devin Funchess. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. A really nice gain of 25 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
Newton gives off to Stewart. They'll wind up getting 4 down to the 36. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
On second down, they run with Stewart. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on third down? The Panthers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. Here's Newton. They find some open field here. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Newton on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, ah, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
This is McCaffrey on the give. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 18 yards there and a first down.
So that's what that elbow in my ribs was all about. You thought they were going to throw the ball as well.
Absolutely. I think everybody thought they were throwing the football. Caught him off guard.
Yeah, I'm telling you, when you have the courage to make that type of a play call, a lot of times you actually get rewarded.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
But it was stopped on that play. But he's had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. So back-to-back plays here where he couldn't get anything on the ground. Now you face a third and 10 and assume you're going to try to pass it, right?
I would think so, because you've tried to run the ball and really it didn't matter who got the ball in the play because there was no space to go. So then I think you step back, throw the ball to try and pick up the first down.
They'll give it up to McCaffrey, and he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash.
Super tough.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. They have not gotten him going at all. Tried to spark something there with a longer throw, unable to complete it.
But you have to keep trying. He's one of their best playmakers. No matter what it says on the scoreboard, you're always trying to get him the football.
To throw on third down, Rodgers. Now he's forced out left. Call it a loss of 12 that time. And that'll bring up fourth down. On now is the Packers punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Strong running by Clay. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10. They'll try and grind some clock. It's Stewart trying to run inside, but nothing there. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
Packer pressure, and down he goes. Kenny Clark in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Newton. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Bird. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Now a first down throw for Newton. Gonna throw right side here, complete. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. To throw on second down, Newton. Toward the sideline, he will have the first down. Good catch. He was able to keep the feet in bounds. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains. On first down, it's Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Clay Matthews in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. And some room to roam now.
There goes Jonathan Stewart. Touchdown, Carolina. Jonathan Stewart, 39 yards. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit. But for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Gano out to kick this one away. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. Rodgers again here on second and 10. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Shaq Thompson from his outside linebacker spot, forcing the sack for a loss of 8. On third and long, it's Rodgers. He's going to wind up and air it out. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked by Darryl Worley. Oh, now he bowls him over.
Especially the corners who've had the receivers on lockdown.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Jonathan Stewart, his 20th carry. And a solid run down inside the 30. Give him 7 yards on the